harvesting wheat today. This truck's full now, ready to go. So I'm gonna jump in and haul it over to our seed warehouse. It's about 15 miles away. We've got about 3 trucks out in the field and 2 combines going. The combines are way over there now in a different field. The wheat's really heavy, so we can't fill it all the way full. This is a pretty full load as it is. So, let's go.
Where we store all our wheat, have to watch it to make sure it doesn't build up too much there, otherwise the auger will overflow. I have the cover off over here so I can show you. Usually we keep it covered because augers are pretty dangerous, but from there, carries it up this auger. Into this building here. It's kind of dark, I don't know if you can see it, but there's an auger along the whole top there and it dumps it in there in the pile. And then as the pile gets too big, we'll move to a new spot and I'll start another pile. And by end of the season, this thing should be pretty full. And then we'll haul it up to Portland throughout the winter. We'll take about a month and haul it up there and they barge it out. This facility works nice because in the winter we can load it and haul it even when it's raining. We don't have to worry about staying dry. go get another one.
I sure have nothing to complain about. Had a long, productive day. No breakdowns. And a nice sunset to top it all off. Love it. I thought I'd show you guys the pea field that I spent this morning cutting. So it's dry peas for seed, and we windrow them with a swather, and then we come back through about a week later and combine them. There's a couple different varieties out here, so we have to keep them separate. And I don't have a ton of experience with the swather, so it's a real trial and patience for me getting it set up right. You have to get down just as low as you can so you don't leave any. And even as it is, we were leaving a little bit here. But and if you go too low, then you're just in the dirt the whole time on the rocks, and you're constantly breaking sections and stuff. So it's really frustrating that way. And I work hard to be patient and not get too down on myself. But after about an hour or so getting set up, I think I finally had it set so I could keep going and make some progress, and got the field knocked out. So let me show you some. They're kind of rubbery right now. It's got some dried up peas in there. I'm sure everyone knows what peas looks like, but thought I'd still show it. And so once they sit and dry for about a week, then they'll shatter a lot easier in the combine, and just be the seed in the combine tank. So yeah, that's that. Maybe I'll get some video of the combine in action in another week. And I'll see you then. thrashing of peas today. It's going pretty good. It's a little dirtier than the tank that we'd like. Some of the pods are going through. But we were having a little trouble. It's kicking too much seed out the back. So we decided to settle for a little dirtier tank and to make sure we get it all. It's only 14 acres of peas, so should be able to finish it today. Just got started about 5 p.m. today, and I don't know, I can go through the night a little bit, make sure we get it done. This is peas for seed. We had a couple different varieties out in this field, and we had to be really careful to clean the combine, make sure to get all the wheat out of it that we combined previous to this. Make sure we have a clean tank so there's nothing else mixed in the seed. It's really important when it's seed stock, keep it separate and clean. We hoped to get to this earlier, but we wanted to finish our wheat before we switch back over to our pea header, the pickup header. Comfortable in these combines. They have the engine in the back of the machine, so it's nice and quiet here in the cab. About 4:30 in the morning, I'm heading over to cut our sugar beets, and it's a clear night, no clouds in the sky, and the moon is really bright, which will definitely help. It's actually casting shadows, it's so bright, and I think I could just about drive with my lights off. Pretty good. had a little trouble this morning with one of the draper belts. It wasn't wanting to spin, it kept stopping on me. And I thought there was a rock in there or something, but after taking it apart, it was all seemed fine. And I think I just had to tighten it up a little bit. Now it seems like it's working on pretty good. So you have to start early in the morning because you hope there's still some dew on it. The plants are a little wet from the night and it keeps the seed from falling off and shattering. When we cut the sugar beets, we have to put an upright section on the header up there to cut down the middle to separate the two passes. You lose a little bit of seed when you do that, but it doesn't make it losing too much. Thought I'd give a little update on our cabbage. What we're working on now is going through and cutting all the females. The males have already been mowed, so once they're done pollinating, once the females and the males are done pollinating, we come through and mow the males, get them out of the way, because we don't want any of that seed from the males to be harvested. They actually both produce seed, but we only want to harvest the females. And so now the stakes and all the strings have been pulled, and we actually come through by hand and clip the bottom of each plant, the females, and combine two female rows into one, and lay them all in the same direction. It's a lot of labor. It takes a lot of time out here. And then we come through with the combine, and we'll combine them in another week or so. We lay them all the same direction so the combine picks them up the best, picks them up like it should. If they're kind of falling all over the place, then the combine will I'll kind of push them and not want to pick them up like it should. But the weeds kind of get out of control towards the end of this crops cycle. It's really hard to control it. So actually before we combined the two female rows into one, we came through with a flail and tried to take care of some of the weeds just to give it a nice place to sit and dry before the combine comes through. These are what the seed pods look like. tiny little things. I think cabbage seed's some of my favorite. It's really pretty. I don't know how well you can see it. Tiny little seed, black. When you get a box full of it, it's really pretty. So, almost done with this crop. Just have to combine it. That's the best part. Sitting in there, just watching it pour in the back, or hopefully pour in the back. Look at the stuff coming out of the combine and make sure you don't see too much seed or unbroken pods coming through. This field's so small, it's only 12 acres, that it's hard to get it set, because by the time you get it set, the field's almost done. I think we took this guy's home. Not seeing too much coming through. The tank's pretty dirty, but again, on these small specialty crops, we'll take the dirtier tank and make sure we get all the seed. Just gotta look at the pods. It looks pretty good. No clouds in the sky today. It's supposed to rain tomorrow. We wanted to really push hard to get this crop combined before tomorrow. It's gonna feel good to have it done.
Yes, sir, man. Just thank you. We got a feed that. Get that stuff all in there, man. And you can just feel that old road just smooth out, man. Just got speed for that. I got up to 3 miles an hour ago, this thing just blew right up. Started pulverizing this thing. He didn't say no more.
What year is this? Is it 40 for you?
I'm on my 40th year for you. Yeah, I'm on my 50th with my wife. I don't know which one will beat me out there, the farmer or the wife.
Well, I'll go back up to the shop and get ready to put some boxes.
Okay.
You meet me up there and we'll unload them?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we'll just unload them. Get it ready.
Vacuum it up.
Vacuum it up. Get it ready for a week. Yeah.
Sure is a lot of work for about 30 minutes of thrashing, huh?
Yeah, that's why I told Linda. She says, see all that work for you to clean this thing up? She says, yeah, I suppose about 30, 45 minutes. We'll be doing it all over again.
I just mean throwing them all along. How much time do we spend out in this field?
Yeah.
Transplanting and staking and stringing and hoeing and all that stuff, and then 30 minutes of thrashing, it's done.
And then taking the males out, watering and everything, and then 30, 45 minutes, you got the whole crop.
Think a box, that stuff's pretty heavy. I mean, I don't want to tip that skid steer over when I lift it up there. Maybe it'll fill like 2/3 full.
Well, a lot of trash.
Yeah, just don't tip me over when you're filling me up.
You have any bent boxes you got?
We got plenty.
Oh, we'll just fill about 2/3 full.
Yeah, I played
safe. We don't want to make a chance. And, but we'll fill about 2 or 3 boxes anyway.
Yeah. You want me to go move this stuff?
I'll get it. Watch it.
You get all that?
Yeah. Watch
it. Like a race car driver.
morning in a row I've come over and set up my camera. I'm hoping to get the beans coming out of the ground. Beans usually come out of the ground over one day or maybe two. And I thought it'd be neat to get a time lapse. It's 5 o'clock. I went out there and replaced the battery last night at 10. And I'm going over this morning to start it up again. I'm trying to get it sun up, sun down. But I hope it's worth it. See what happens, see what it looks like. Got the camera set up. I thought I'll show you my setup. This is my camera. I drove a spike into the ground here. I welded this a couple nights ago. Flat piece on top, and the magnet can sit on that. And this works good because I can pull the back off and change the battery without it moving. Yesterday, I just changed the battery every 2 hours, which is fine because I was just working in the field next to it over there. But today, I don't know where I'm gonna be. I could be a ways away. So I drug out a car battery, put some alligator clips on it, and then using the USB charger plugged into that, I think that will hopefully keep it running all day. At least a lot longer than I went yesterday. We'll see though how it goes. I read that you're supposed to use the 1 amp versus the 2 amp. My charger here has two different plugins, one's for a 1 amp, one's for a 2 amp. I read that it can get a little hot, which is what I was worried about. So, I hope this is worth it. This is the second day and the beans are coming out of the ground a little bit here. So, I think it should look pretty neat.
Sun's just about to come up.